Pascal Juma ventured into art at a very tender age, and because of his many years' expertise, he is generous enough to share his knowledge with his apprentices at the Bobea Art Center.
My name is Pascal Chuma. I'm a creative soul from Bobea Art Center, where we nurture talents for both the children and the youth. Yes, we came to realize that many children have the talent and needs to be supported. That's why we came up with this art center. Then I realized that art was my first language when I was 5 years old. That's when I decided to express myself and release my energy through drawing and painting. I'm inspired by the environment I live in, the female forms, then my emotional inspiration, and then environmental conservation, mm-hmm. and even politics. I get inspired. That's when I inspire people. I tell the people what they should do. All that I feel, and my dreams as well.
Whilst admitting that Kenya does not have many art lovers, Pascal says that art still fetches a pretty penny, and anyone worth his or her salt can depend on art as a form of income.
Most people don't appreciate art here in Kenya, but because they do not know, they do not come to us and ask more about what we do or this industry does, is it creative or not. But what I will tell most people or most young people is that it is a very lucrative industry. And if parents can actually maybe change their mind or wake up to some extent, they think that art is for those ones who didn't do well in school. They go, like, if when we hear it during the, when they announce for the KCP results, they just say that if you, those ones who failed, they can do kazi ya mikono. So you understand, those people are illiterate in that they did not know what they talk about.
He draws his inspiration from natural phenomena.
I'm diverse. I do political story, or I do popular art, and also engage in telling human rights stories through paintings. And we find that most of my paintings, yes, they talk, okay, you can see so many female forms, but the reason why I do that is that I try to highlight stories of women which nobody talks about them. So even female, even issues of child rights, like female gender maturation, child labor, and also orphans, about food. So those are the paintings I've done, and I've made an impact to so many people in our community. And also I've sold those pieces, obviously, to some individuals who feel that it is a story that touches them.
For every venture undertaken in this life, there has to be ups and downs, and Pascal has had many challenges along the way.
The most challenges I've faced as an artist in Kenya since I started painting in 2010 as a full-time painter is that most of our people here in Kenya, they don't really support art in Kenya. They don't want to create a market for art in Kenya. Since we have so many talented young people who are very talented, but they don't want to support us by buying our art, acquiring our paintings, and then so that they can make their offices. You know, the offices are stones. They need to beautify the offices, their homes. They need to make them warm, cozy, welcoming, inviting. Mm-hmm. But they do not want that.
To the aspiring artist, he encourages them to follow their passion with the knowledge that painting is not only for those that failed in academics, as previously thought, but a real profession to be reckoned with.
No matter who you are, if you have the talent and you use it well, it is a creative industry, it can change your life, and you can also touch so many souls. If our parents can actually open up their mind and see art as work, not a job, as work, and then I think even our economy will improve. Even the tourism industry, art is about tourism, And then when I talk about tourism, we find that we have same beaches, same hotels, but we do not have same art and culture in Kenya, so, or in Africa, or in the world. So instead of people, like when they come, they need to know more about art in Kenya, because we talk about our culture. Even if you look at this painting, it's about hunters and gatherers. So what about hunters and gatherers? We have a story that we do in paintings. And then the other thing, we find that most people don't know where to spend their time. When you are free, people spend most of their time in restaurants the whole day. So instead of coming like a place like Bobby Art Center, gallery, you meet the artist who are painting, and then you ask questions, then you learn more.